afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the campus of Pittsburgh High School. I'd like to direct your attention to the area directly in front of home plate and introduce you to our district's coordinator of athletics, Mr. Gregory Strong.
Good afternoon. Thank you for all attending. What a beautiful day to play a game of baseball. What a great day to honor a legend of the Pittsburgh community. We are here today to honor Mr. Joseph P. Renovar for a lifetime of dedicated service to the city of Pittsburgh and to the students of the Pittsburgh Unified School District. Joining me on the field today to honor our members of the PUSD School Board. Board President, Mr. Deshaun Warridge. Board Trustee, Dr. Laura Cancianella. Board Trustee, Dwayne Smith. Board Trustee, George Miller. And of course, the man of the hour, Mr. Joe Renovar. We are also very honored to have the superintendent and her cabinet members. Please welcome PUSD Superintendent, Dr. Janet Schultz. Assistant Superintendent Norma Gonzalez, along with Executive Director Anthony Molina, Director of Educational Services Eileen Chen, Deputy Superintendent Mr. Enrique Palacios, along with Pittsburgh High School Principal Todd Whitmire, and Head Baseball Coach Marco Cartagena. At this time, I would like to turn it over to School Board President, Mr. Deshaun Warridge, for a few words.
So, I want to start off by thanking everybody for coming today. You know, today we're here to thank you. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Put it right out to your mouth!
I want to thank everybody for coming here today in honor of a man who needs no introduction. A man who has given his lifetime, to building up the city that we call home. You know, Mr. Joseph Renovar has been a coach, he's been a teacher, he's been a life administrator, and now he's a board member. And he's going to continue the legacy that is Pittsburgh. You know, as we move on and grandkids and kids are coming, we'll all be able to say that we have a field named after a man who is a legend in himself. So I want to keep it words for you and say thank you all for coming once again.
Thank you, Mr. Coach. Again, all you have to do is look around the crowd today. It's going to be alumni, former players, former students that have joined us here today to honor Mr. Renovar. Next up, I would like to introduce a former player and lifelong friend of Mr. Renovar, Mr. Tim Galley.
Thank you, Greg. Welcome, everybody. It's an honor to introduce Joe Renovar to you. It really needs very little introduction. Just a lifetime of achievement and commitment to this community. And as a former player of his, the things that he left us with, an unquenchable desire to succeed, driving desire to compete, those things stayed with all of us all of our lives, and we'll always be grateful to Joe for teaching us those things. No introduction of Joe would be complete without at least one Joe Renovar story. And as you may know, there are many, but I'll stick to one of the more legendary. We used to play our games at the old city park, and that backstop back there was about 75 feet high and was well back from home plate. We were playing Clayton Valley one day, and Joe Bojardo was on the mound. Joe was a big, strong kid. Another couple runners on, Joe in it and into a stretch, and he went to throw a curveball and it slipped out of his hand. And it not only went over the batter, it went over the screen, and it went over the stand. The Clayton Valley coach, knowing Joe well, yells, "Don't run, don't run. It's some kind of trick play." And Joe, who never missed the opportunity for a line, walks partway out to the field and says, Joe, if you want baseballs, just tell me. Don't throw them out to your mother in the parking lot." Joe did everything with a great sense of humor, great drive, great purpose. The fact that he continues to serve the district and the city today is further testimony to his roots here in this community and his love of this community. There could be no better honor than to name this field after Joe Renovar. It's my great honor to introduce Joe. Joe? Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here for me, for being here for the community. Thank you. This is a great distinction to be honored this way. I would like to thank the athletic coordinator Greg Strong and Coach Mario Cartagena and Director Anthony Molina for making this possible. I also like to thank the school board, Dr. Schultz, our superintendent, and our staff for accepting this recommendation. Baseball has always been my first love. Ever since my dad took me, a four-year-old, to the empty parking lot near our home on East 2nd Street in Pittsburgh and taught me the game of baseball. That empty lot is gone now, but not the memories. Since then, I've always wanted to be a professional baseball player. Even when I played other sports, I was always worried about getting hurt and not being able to play. I played for the American Legion team, the local city team, the Pittsburgh High School, the University of San Francisco. I even played ball in the Army. I was always looking for a chance to play baseball. So finally, in my junior year of college in 1954, I decided to sign with the New York Yankees. But then in 1960, I was offered a position with the Pittsburgh School District to teach and coach in my hometown. Now this is the time when there were just two major leagues in baseball. So I had to decide whether to try to make it into big leagues as a 27-year-old, or teach in my hometown where my family and friends lived and there was a little more security. Being considered an old baseball player, I decided to accept the offer from Pittsburgh. Then the major league started to expand, and of course, because of that, many, many times I wondered, maybe I should have stayed. Maybe I could have been a major leaguer. But that would mean a different life, a different town, maybe a different profession, and maybe different friends. This wonderful offer today just solidifies that I made the right choice. What do I have in this life? I have a beautiful wife, wonderful children and grandchildren. I live in a great town, and I have friends that I love. That empty lot that I started to learn baseball is gone. But now I have this field where baseball will be played and memories will be made. So again, I thank you for this honor and making me realize that I have a wonderful life. Just like Jimmy Stewart in the movie, It's a Wonderful Life. Even though they're gone, I'm sure Jack Becker and Smitty Candace would agree. So again, thank you very much for honoring me this way. Go Pirates!
Superintendent Dr. Schultz for the presentation of a plaque for Mr. Renovar.
Hello, everyone. It is my great honor to present Joseph Peter Renovar with this plaque. I'm going to read the inscription on the plaque. Joseph Peter Renovar, born October 1st, 1933 in Pittsburgh, California, graduated from Pittsburgh High School as a decorated three-sport student athlete. His athletic accomplishments include playing on the undefeated 1951 San Francisco Dons football team and 6 seasons of minor league baseball in the New York Yankees organization. Mr. Renovar returned to Pittsburgh in 1960 as a teacher at Hillview Junior High School and spent the next 34 years as a teacher and administrator in the Pittsburgh Unified School District. During his tenure with the district, Mr. Renovar spent 11 seasons as the Pittsburgh High School baseball coach. He led the baseball team to a 1968 championship and became the first person in Pittsburgh high school history to win a championship as a player and as a head coach. To date, Mr. Renovar has served the Pittsburgh community as a 19-year veteran of the Pittsburgh Unified School District Board. In recognition of Joseph P. Renovar's service and dedication to the community of Pittsburgh and to the students of Pittsburgh Unified School District, this field is named in his honor on the 14th of April, 2018. Thank
you, Dr. Schultz. That is a replica of the plaque that will hang on the board to honor Mr. Joe Renovar for a lifetime of service. At this time, we would like to unveil the field dedication. If I can all direct your attention behind you to Mr. Chris Leffel, who will hopefully unveil the signage for us. Mr. Leffel, sir. And one last task for Mr. Renovar. I can now call up Executive Director of Ed Services, Mr. Anthony Molina, to properly equip Mr. Renovar for today's ceremonial first pitch, wearing his old number 9 jersey from Pittsburgh High School. If I can also call up Lucas Camrude, Mr. Renovar's grandson, to catch the ceremonial first pitch. Dorian, a lifelong friend of Joe, could not be here today, but he did pre-record a singing of the national anthem. If I could ask you to all please rise.
Through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we whistle gallantly streaming. On the rocket's red flare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the inaugural game at the Joseph P. Arenivar Field. Today's game is between the visiting Nation Valley Warriors and your host, Pittsburgh Pirates. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the campus of Pittsburgh High School. I'd like to direct your attention to the area directly in front of home plate and introduce you to our district's coordinator of athletics, Mr. Gregory Strong.
Good afternoon. Thank you for all attending. What a beautiful day to play a game of baseball. What a great day to honor a legend of the Pittsburgh community. We are here today to honor Mr. Joseph P. Arenivar for a lifetime of dedicated service to the city of Pittsburgh and to the students of the Pittsburgh Unified School District. Joining me on the field today to honor our members of the PUSD School Board. Board President, Mr. Deshaun Warridge. Board Trustee, Dr. Laura Cancianella. Board Trustee, Dwayne Smith. Board Trustee, George Miller. And of course, the man of the hour, Mr. Joe Renovar. We are also very honored to have the superintendent and her cabinet members. Please welcome PUSD Superintendent, Dr. Janet Schultz. Assistant Superintendent Norma Gonzalez, along with Executive Director Anthony Molina, Director of Educational Services Eileen Chen, Deputy Superintendent Mr. Enrique Palacios, along with Pittsburgh High School Principal Todd Whitmire, and Head Baseball Coach Marco Cartagena. At this time, I would like to turn it over to School Board President, Mr. Deshaun Warridge, for a few words.